Okay, we're recording. And just had a great week last week. Did two deals last week. Sometimes things work out really well. I'm still hibernating here in Pinehurst, North Carolina. We've got a lot of things to do today. We're going to have our open forum. We're going to talk about nominations for the Max Award, the Guts Max Award, the highest award in sales that I have to give. It's a beautiful, I'll show you a picture of it here. Where is it? Let's see. Let me find my pictures here. I got it here somewhere. Photos. There we go. Let's see here. Let me share my screen with you guys. This is the Max Award. I give this away every year. That was last year's 2020. It's beautiful. It's on plexiglass. It's I think a 60-minute timer, and it says you gave good phone, and it's the award I like to give to acknowledge somebody who actually showed guts, who actually used the system, who made money. And this year's going to be tough because I've got three people that I'm going to nominate, and we'll get to that in a little while. It's really somebody who has mastered the control of persuasion and influence, getting other people to listen, getting them to agree, going to the bank. Absolutely. We have our newest guy here, Davis, introduced it, Mr. Opamen, right? You said the K is silent?
Yeah, the K is silent.
Opamen, that's definitely got to be an Irish name.
No.
Okay. O'Reilly, O'Murphy, Opamen, that's right.
No, not Irish, not Irish.
Tell us a bit, introduce yourself.
So my name is Davis Opamen. I am from Houston, Texas. I'm in real estate. I specifically deal with mobile homes. That's the niche that I'm in. I got connected with Claude, watched one of his YouTube videos and one of his interviews, and I was immediately just connected with him, and I reached out for him to him from there. I'm really excited about just learning about I wanted to join in more so on the consulting side, but understanding that gut sales method, is inclusive to all of that. So glad to connect with you guys. I'm looking forward to growing, and hopefully I can be a gut salesperson. I'm going to be a good salesperson in the near future. So,
But when you say near future, that's something prospects say to me. Claude, we're going to do business in the near future. Okay, what does near future mean? Is that a wishy-washy answer?
yeah, that's wishy-washy.
Okay, when are you going to be a gut salesman and make money?
I'm going to be a gut salesman
Give me
by
a
the end of
range. 30 days, 60, 90, never.
60 days. 60 days.
Okay, 60 days or less. And what it defined as making money, getting on the phone, feeling confident and wonderful about yourself, like Mr. Ben Jasso does every day. And it's just we've all had that sales reluctant. I think we all have. I have. I have had days where I had so many negative phone calls, that it almost got me depressed, or it did get me depressed. And I did. What happens when we're depressed and we're running a business where we have to direct market to people? What happens? What do we stop doing?
Talking to people.
Yeah. What happens? And if we don't talk to people, what happens to our bank account?
Goes down.
Yeah. Gotta speak to people. And so I think one of the best things about guts is it makes selling, it gives you a system. Systems are good. It gives you reinforced repetitive training. Somebody helped me. There was a guy in Texas. There was a program in Texas, Waco, Texas. And I forgot his name, and he used to sell a course, and he called it spaced repetition. He said doing something repetitively, practicing, and that's why we do the role playing today. We do it on Mondays. We do it on Saturdays and everything. Help, Paul, is it Paul Meyer? Somebody go. I think Ben, your dog is upside down with his paws up behind you there. It is the funniest picture in the world there.
And she does.
That is the funniest.
Siberian Husky.
He's got a dead dog behind him. Kids and dogs always steal the
Right?
show, don't they?
Always.
Unless Dave Skolnick comes in with lox and bagels and coffee for everyone. Absolutely. I think Paul Meyer, and it was the SIM program. Somebody Google it for me. Yeah, Paul Meyer, M-E-Y-E-R. What was it? And he had a program. I think it was about motivation and everything. And it was called space. And he was really big on spaced repetition. Anything you do on a consistent, regular basis, like role playing in sales. Do we have a lot of variables in sales? I mean, different stalls, objections, situations. We have all these variables, millions, right? I don't even think we could count them all. And so we go into it with a script, but scripts don't work because people buy emotionally immediately. They make decisions very quickly when they get emotional, but scripts don't activate that. So the spaced repetition, anyone find Paul Meyer? It was SIM or something like that out of Waco, Texas. Old business motivational type sales training pro. Had some good stuff.
How did you spell his last name?
I think it was M-E-Y-E-R. Paul Meyer. I might be wrong.
Paul J. Meyer.
Thank you. Yeah. What was the name of his company, Sean? SMC or something like that?
I want to say it was SMI, but I'm not sure.
I think you're right. And he had some really good motivational materials. He was kind of more like the motivational speaker. If you notice, most of the training programs out there in motivational, real estate, sales, most of them they deal with motivation. You've got to get your head on right. You know, you've got to knock on 100 doors. And if 100 people say no, walk in the sunshine and knock on another 100 doors. They do a little bit on the strategies. Real estate, a lot of gurus love to talk about strategies and everything. I have chosen to focus on the one thing that changed my life, that financially, and that was, Stephen, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
You're late. We're going to have to punish you later. Oh, but it was.
He's got to clean the erasers.
There you go. From Suzette Galian to everyone, do all the good you can by all the, I couldn't read the whole chat there, all the time you can to all the people you can, as long as you can, Paul J. Meyer. Suzette, what did you look that up? Okay, good. And that was the one takeaway I had from him, spaced repetition. Just constantly practicing I practiced with my mentor, Max. I role played a lot with him. That's kind of where I got it from. He loved to role play. I'd give him problems and situations, and he was a very Socratic teacher. Okay. And a Socratic teacher. We have a teacher in the room, Bill Pinnell. Bill, you're retired now, or you're not teaching anymore. Were you a Socratic teacher?
definitely the last 15 years.
Isn't it better to incorporate the people you're trying to teach, get them involved, talking, participate, rather than standing up there and reading from some book or something like that?
Definitely. Having the interaction is a big thing.
Don't you love, I think fondly of the teachers where there was more participation.
Mm-hmm.
Remember some classes, 45 minutes seemed like hours. And some classes seem like 5 minutes because they were actually interesting.
Yeah.
And that's kind of my philosophy on teaching and stuff. And that's how you gain those skill sets by every day. I'll let you guys in on a little secret. You ready? I learned so much by practicing with my students, and every day it enhances my own sales ability because, you know, you warm up before you do any activity. Should you warm up a little? Do it in sports, in tennis, in baseball? Yeah. Isn't it good to warm up a little? How about in sales? To spontaneously pick up the phone and start calling and talking to people. Yeah. SMI, Sean has it. Success Motivation International. Sean, do they still exist? I'm talking about.
Yeah, the website, if you go to Success SMI, the website has changed. He died in 2009. But the company is still, you know, the products and stuff are still available and they're still doing stuff. Okay. But the website name has changed.
He had He had some really good philosophies. I really enjoyed it. We have our new guy here, Stefan. Introduce yourself. You're another new guy. Tell everybody about yourself, where you live, what you're here for.
Yeah, I'm here for, you know, like everybody else, given good phone. I'm from Jersey. Right now I'm in Florida, you know, real estate. Yeah, I'm grateful for networking with everybody, and I hope to learn a lot from all you guys.
Steven's from my old summer house, up Tom's River, New Jersey.
Jersey Shore.
The Jersey Shore. Some of the best days of my ill-spent youth were at the Jersey Shore. Under the boardwalk, boardwalk.
Right.
Great song.
Yeah, now you'll find nothing but feral cats.
Who did that song, Under the Boardwalk? Quick trivia moment. Who did it? Come on. Who did it?
Was it the Drifters?
Wasn't it? His name came in my head and everything.
Benny.
What's his Siri. Name?
The Drifter.
Who sang Under the Boardwalk? We're going to be embarrassed here.
Benny somebody.
No.
Was it King?
Oh, great song.
Great song.
Who sang Under the Boardwalk? The Drifters did it.
Killing.
I have the Drifters here. I thought it was a famous who did that song? Okay, I'll look it up later. I thought it was a famous individual singer. It was the Drifters. Anyway, good for you. Glad you could join us.
John wins. He got the trivia.
There we go. So practice makes perfect. Open forum time, and then we're going to talk about nominations for the Maxi Award, the highest award in gut sales. Anybody have an open question or something they'd a success story or something or a role play they'd like to do today? This is your time. Pick the brain of the collective intelligence of this very beautiful audience. Go ahead, Bill. You go first and then Ben.
Quick question for you. And I know you've covered this before, but I've got a guy that contacts me every now and then and is basically sucking me for information, and I can't get him to convert to be consulting. And so what I end up doing is I put him off, or I put, I say, I got to go now. I've got another call with one of my clients. And then I hit the road. But I need help with the next time he calls to nip it in the bud and either put up or shut up. I'm trying to be a nice guy.
Okay. Every time you get somebody, look who's here. Amir, the legend. How are you? What is your son must be 15 years old by now. I haven't seen him in a long time.
Almost. How are you doing?
Good. Good to see you, buddy.
This looks like a Lex Luthor convention.
Yeah.
Mr. Creed.
Before we get into how to control a guy who's trying to pick your brain, do you ever get somebody on the phone, you know you're not going to do business with them. They're just wasting your time. They have no money. They don't own the property. They're, what do we used to call them? A looky-loo?
Okay. Tire kicker.
A tire kicker. Is there any other metaphors that I can think of? And the best way to do that is ask them for money. And they'll go away. Yeah. They'll go right off the phone call or the Zoom call very quickly.
they'll lose your number.
Yeah. When you get somebody calling you, when somebody comes into a car dealership looking at car, just looking, you get somebody who responds to an ad, a video, or calls you up. Why? You got to ask yourself, this is where empathy is another word. I akin it to mind reading. Why are they really calling you? They want information. They want freebies, don't they? But they usually don't want to make a commitment. At that point, no commitment. No, I'm thinking about it. I'll talk to my spouse, my dog, my goldfish. I'll get back to you in the near distant future. So they want to pick your brain. So this is where guts, the psychology of guts, really comes into being. the three most powerful words in Guts are?
I don't know.
So, Bill, you play that guy who calls me up, and you want to ask questions. Remember, there's always stroking and nurturing. And what you want to do is suck him into your vortex, your little vacuum, your little room here. He's going to have the drawbridge up already. Well, just, you know, I say he might stroke and nurture. Do you ever notice how when a prospect wants something from you, what do? Do they stroke and nurture? This is a nurture. Don't they compliment you usually?
Definitely.
Oh, don't we all do that? Why do we do that, by the way? What's the mindset? Why do we compliment somebody we want something from that we don't want to pay for?
We want them to like us so they'll give us the information.
Right. You know, flattery will get you everything, won't it?
Definitely.
Don't people love when you acknowledge their presence, their work, or something? Yes. Isn't that like the best super stroke in the world?
Yes.
I love your blouse. I love that bright, what is that, orange or red blouse? I love that blouse. And you got a very tasteful sweater over it. You must take a lot of time for your presence on video. I bet you do, right? Your clothing is beautiful. It looks very expensive. Huh. Can't hear you. No sound. Oops. Well, well, we can then move on to Ben Jasso's t-shirt. Ben.
Oh, yeah. Aloha t-shirt.
Aloha. I have a closet full of Hawaiian shirts. Claudia and I spent a lot of time with Kauai. Suzette was there before the pandemic. What was that, January 2020?
Can you hear me now?
19? Now I can hear you. Yes.
Yeah, 2019. It was great.
2019. That was that was like yesterday. We had a Guts reunion and seminar in that, remember that beautiful house overlooking the water, and you could see the sea turtles, and we drank Mai Tais in this garden with these giant plants and everything like that. Oh,
okay. Was that great? Can't wait to go back.
We will. We are going to go back. I said earlier this year, I thought I hope it would be this year. Who knew that we would get Delta plus plus or whatever it is right now. Mm-hmm. And everything. So it'll probably be next year. And I want to do a beer get together at my at David Skolnick's favorite beer garden there, Ballast Point in downtown San Diego. That was a lot of fun too.
Of people flew in just for that one day training and that evening.
Yeah, that was that. And then we had the one in Kauai, which is wonderful. I'm going to do something special next year because we've been locked up too long. We're human beings. We like to social. Do people like to talk? Do they like to socialize?
Yes.
But they will not start the conversation, will they?
Right.
Unless you're me in a restaurant. What does your Uncle Claude do in a restaurant when he sees another table nearby with great looking food? I'm a Gemini, so I change my mind constantly. Geminis do that.
You ask for a bite.
I haven't gone that far yet. I've not gone that far yet, but I do. What do you ask somebody? You want to start a conversation. You don't want to be interrupt them too much, but you see some food you really like. What do you do?
God, that looks fantastic. What is that?
What is that? Could you tell me about your wonderful dish or your food or something? You see somebody walking a dog. Oh, I love your beagles. Oh, is that what made you buy a beagle? Do you like beagles? Are they easy to train and walk and stuff? Isn't it easy when you maybe go to something other than personal? I went to Suzette before. I said, I love your ensemble. You know, it's the way you took your time to dress in such nice clothing and everything like that. You probably spent a lot of time and money on your wardrobe, don't you, Suzette?
Thanks for noticing, Claude. As a matter of fact, I do. I want to look good in camera now that everything is through camera.
Okay.
Bill and Ben, that's a great hairstyle.
There you go. Could I buy you? You've been so kind, so nice. You're so friendly. Could I buy you a drink?
Oh, that's very nice, Claude. Of course.
Oh, good. I don't have to ask your husband, right?
No, he'll be okay.
Got to be careful with these Guts moves. Absolutely. Bill, go ahead. Let's go into that role play and I'll show you how to handle the I want something for nothing.
Hey, Claude, how you doing?
I'm doing okay. Thanks for asking, Bill. How can I help you today? What would you like to talk about?
Well, you know, I've been trying to get my advertising up to, you know, get more people to help the homeowners out with the lease purchase and that. And I was wondering, you know, what can I do to, you know, what are you doing to get the advertising and getting the lease purchasing going?
Oh, that's a great bunch of questions and everything. You mind if I just ask you one or two? Could you tell me, what do you do, Bill, exactly?
Well, I'm a software guy, but I'm trying to help people because people teach nonsense with the lease purchase, and I think it's screwing the homeowner. So I'm trying to help homeowners.
I'm confused. Can you help me? You said you're a software guy. What do you work for, Microsoft or Adobe or something like that?
Yeah, I work for a company in dealing with software, but I also have real estate on the side.
Oh, when you say on the side, you mean you do deals, you buy deals, you teach deals? I'm not sure if I understand.
Yeah, I do deals, and I try and help homeowners. I've written a book. I've got a website, and I'm trying to help homeowners.
You probably know more than me, man. It's great. How long you been doing real estate? And you wrote a book and everything?
A couple of years.
Oh my gosh. I don't understand. What's the real problem here? Help me out. I'm not sure if I understand.
Well, I can't seem to get my phone ringing.
Ringing for what exactly?
Well, for people to call and ask me for help.
Help with?
With doing rent to own.
Oh, okay. So you're not getting enough phone calls? Is that what I'm hearing?
Definitely.
Why would you want people to call you up to sell your
book? So that I can sell them so I can either sell them my book or help them, you know, hire me as a consultant.
To help them out. Here it comes. Finally,
that's what I'm looking to do.
Okay, time out. You just saw a great example. What would the amateur sales guy sound like, Davis? Let's have somebody else get it. Davis, what would the amateur guy, a prospect calls you up, hey, I want to ask you a bunch of questions about real estate and everything. What's the amateur guy do?
He's just going to give them the information.
What's it sound like? Go ahead. Give a little role play here.
Okay. I introduce myself. You know, hey, I'm Davis. How are you doing today, Claude?
I'm doing good. Listen, I saw your webpage. I'm so interested in your mobile home stuff. And I love what you have. And I just have a few questions on that. Those mobile homes, can you rent them out nightly, monthly, long-term leases? What kind of contracts do you use also? I love your webpage though, man. It's great stuff.
Yeah. Thanks, Claude. Yeah. So you can rent them out monthly. You can do it weekly as well too. You can rent them out yearly.
Could I see your contracts? I'm sure we'll do business in the future.
Sure. Just give me your email. You know, anytime I can give that to you. What's your email, by the way? I can just send that to you now.
You know what's scary about this role play? You're doing this way too well right now.
I know.
You're doing this way too good.
I'm in the same position with Bill. Like, I'm naturally very giving of my information, honestly. And it gets me all the time. It gets me all the time.
Let me ask you, and promise you guys won't get mad at me, Bill and Davis.
Definitely.
Are you nice guys?
Yes, I can be.
Yes.
I think you're nice guys. Your mom raised you right.
Yeah.
You're polite. You hold doors open for old ladies and things like you're gentlemen.
Yeah.
You're nice guys. Does that mean because you have good manners, you're a class act, does that mean you have to give away stuff for free all day long?
No. Definitely not.
It's the mindset.
Yeah.
Okay. What did I do? So you did a great job, Davis. Really too good a job. Okay. What did I do with Bill? I almost played like I took a stupid pill or something. What did I do with Bill there? I mean, that was the complete opposite of Davis. What did you guys see in here?
Well, you acted pretty ignorant to the information, or as far as what he was asking. You acted like you didn't know any of it. You're just being extremely inquisitive, you know, as far as understanding what he really wanted. Just kept on asking him questions, and You turned the script on him.
Yeah. Anyone else? Sales, real sales, real gut selling, persuade. It's called persuasion, to persuade another, to influence what they're thinking, what they're doing. When you take over the conversation and you go into PowerPoint mode, oh, let me show you the next slide and the next slide, and here's my script and everything like that, they kind of lose track because he just might want to know answers to a few questions. The art and science of persuasion is to get the prospect, this is important, take away a moment here, is to get the prospect to become the salesperson.
Right.
Can you imagine the prospect is so emotionally involved, so stimulated by the way you're saying, gee, I don't know. Could you help me out? I'm not sure if I understand. Did you hear me say all those things constantly? When I do that, that forces the prospect to get emotionally involved and start sharing their story, their information, their motivation. What is that? It turns the prospect into the salesperson. They qualify themselves. They give their own presentation. If you get really good at this, has anyone here ever had the prospect close themselves?
Yeah.
It's Mount Everest. Yeah. It's as good as it gets. Who's had that experience?
I have.
What's it like to have the prospect close themselves?
What the fourth best feeling, Claude? Is that one?
I think it would be number two, but that's my feel.
Okay.
You know? you obviously have a much more interesting life. Getting the prospect to close them. You know what? Have you ever had a prospect say, you know what, Claude, let's just do this. I like the home. I like your service. I like your property. I like your note. Let's just go ahead and do this. Stephen, have you ever had that experience? You're shaking your head. Yes, there.
It's funny because I just had a contract. I got a contract on Saturday from a guy from a multifamily over in Philly. And when I got on the phone with him, first thing he says was, oh, you know, I've got a lot of calls from guys, you know, they're all trying to give me 200. They're all trying to give me 200,000. I said, whoa. I said, I haven't offered you anything. So, I mean, I'm not one of those guys. I haven't offered you 200. You haven't even told me what's going on yet. So why don't you tell me what's going on?
What would you like to see happen next?
100%. And so he just goes into the whole spiel of like telling me about the property he's doing. And I just had him talking.
It's kind of like you're a patient. You walk into the doctor, the lawyer, the accountants, you're walking into a professional's room. They don't know what your pain or problem is yet. So what are we going to, and they're busy. If they're professional people, they might have a waiting room full of people. What do they have to do to get to the point, to get to the information quickly?
Questions.
Question-based selling is the way to go. So we do a little bit. We do the little pattern interrupts. We do the redirections. We do the I don't knows. All these serve a purpose for getting the prospect to take over and do all. You know what's really great? When you're sitting back and you're taking notes and then you even tell the prospect, hey Mr. I lost somebody here. Where did we go? Oh, there he is, Bill. Bill, Mr. Pinnell, you mind if I take notes here? This is really great stuff you're sharing with me. This is going to help me to give you a couple solutions here today.
Wow, yeah, definitely take notes.
So you said you're in the real estate business. You do lease purchasing. You have a book you wrote. You also want to consult. You also want people to bring you deals. Is that what, but you want, I think this is a marketing a problem that you're having. Tell me, am I wrong here?
No, definitely haven't. I want to know what I can do to market.
Oh, okay. Well, you've been in business a long time. What kind of marketing have you done previously?
Well, you know, postcards, roadside signs, you know, the big billboards and that kind of stuff.
Roadside signs, billboard. This is great. Thank you. Keep them talking. It's like when you're writing, give them a cookie. Oh, this is great stuff. And what else? Anything on the web or anything like that? Or
well, just my website. And I have paid for click ads on like Facebook and stuff like that.
And you're getting leads from it. You're making the money you want. You're getting enough leads, right?
Not really. I mean, that's why I'm having trouble.
Oh,
and that's why I called you.
Okay. But that's not affecting your income for this wonderful business you have, right?
It most definitely is.
Time out. There's a thing in law school they teach you, never ask a question you don't know the answer to ahead of time. Okay. Otherwise you get embarrassed in court. Okay. What did I just ask, Bill? That's not affecting your income. Now I know it is, but why am I saying it? Why am I so obvious here?
And the closing.
You want him to say it.
I'm going positive. Is that a positive redirection? You're making good money, right? I mean, you're getting enough leads and everything, right? That's a positive redirection. Where's the pendulum going to swing now?
Imagine for a moment.
Negative.
He's going to go negative, and he's going to tell me now. You're not making the money you want, Bill, with all this time and money you're spending and everything. What round numbers? How much are you spending per month on all this marketing and pay per click and postcards and everything and virtual?
Probably assistants? At least $3,000.
$3,000 a month. That's $36,000 a year. That's a lot of money.
Yes.
And how many leads are you getting?
Two or three
a day, a week, a month.
A month.
Oh, okay. Two of that. And out of that two or three, the close ratio is 1 out of 3, 0 out of 3, or?
About 0.5 out of three.
Well, okay. And that doesn't generate, and that's not, is that, no, that's not generating the income. Are you getting a return on that $3,000 per month investment? You must be.
Not at all. I'm in the hole every month.
Wow. This is a huge problem.
Yes.
And you've been doing this for how long?
Been trying different things up and down, but doing it for the last 2 years. Like 2 this. 2 years,
$3,000 a month. It's a 0.5%, less than that return. Oh my gosh. Okay, off the role play. What am I doing to Bill right now?
You're burying him in shit.
You're very eloquent today, David.
He's about this high.
What happens? Do you ever get anybody ever get a paper cut? Don't we hate paper cuts? Yeah. Oh, nothing hurts. Yeah. Like, do you ever get a paper cut and you didn't have a Band-Aid on it or something, and you squeeze some lemon juice or something acidic, and what happens? It hurts all over again, doesn't
all
it?
All over again.
All you make over him feel again. The pain.
What a taint. What am I doing to poor Bill Pinnell right now?
Rubbing his nose in it.
Rubbing his
making
nose
him,
in
it. Making him
I'm
feel
feeling
the pain.
Real bad.
Real bad. Why am I trying? We're going deep here, guys, because I don't want to lose this moment here. This is really, why am I trying to make a happy prospect who came to me, a warm prospect? Why am I trying to make him feel bad? Why? The big one.
Get him emotionally involved to make a decision.
Say it again. That was brilliant.
To get emotionally involved to make a decision.
Yes.
And I'm the more, what's the pain?
Somebody help me. What's the $1 million rule? I can't let a session go without that rule that'll make you a millionaire. What is it?
People make immediate decisions emotionally and then justify them later logically.
Logically. So the more pain I get you in. So I'm like the Marquis de Sade, Assad. I'm inflicting pain. I might be bringing up things you never thought about again. How has that affected your lifestyle, taking vacations? How does your significant other feel about it? Have you, are you wearing your shoes a little bit, a couple hundred miles longer than you wanted to because your money's all going for advertising? So you're building on this to take them from a 5 or a 6 to an 8, 9, or 10, aren't we? Dave, I see you. So we're trying to get them up there to an 8, 9, or 10 on the guts barometer. People at 8, 9, or 10, can we close them?
Yes.
Are they
yes.
emotionally involved? That's when we go, because now we've qualified and we got to the second step. Now we go to the commitment to close. Go ahead, Dave.
I was just going to say, you indirectly found out he's spending $3,000 a month. You know he's got money to spend, and it'd be better off giving it to you to help him solve this problem instead of throwing it at the wall and seeing if anything sticks.
Yeah. So now we know he's spending $3,000 a month. In terms of qualification, we know he's, and when we qualify someone, we go from agenda. Can I ask you, can I have permission to ask you a few questions? And then you ask me a few, and let's decide if we can figure this out together. And you don't have to say you'll get back to me if you're not comfortable with my solutions or ideas. Is that all right with you, Mr. Pinnell?
Yes, definitely. Oh,
can I call you Bill? I'm Claude, by the way.
Yes, Claude.
Oh, I feel like I know you already. Thank you. Then you go to the qualification. What did we get in qualification? We knew he was a 6 or a 7. We just got him into an 8, 9, 10. Motivation is real important. Are they motivated? Okay. Are they emotionally involved? Number two, do they have the money? What little clue did he give us about his financial situation? He gave us two clues, actually.
He's already spending it.
He's already spending it. He's spending $3,000 a month over 2 years. Okay, $36,000 a month on that. So he's spending money. What about his other means of employment? Anyone pick that up?
Yep.
He's a software engineer. What do software engineers make, right? That's a good, that's a well-paid position, isn't it? So can we assume that maybe he has some money, he's working, he has some money, and he's already spending money. Mm-hmm. And everything. So is that part of the qualification process?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Then we go, so we've already done number one, what's his level of motivation? Number two, does he have the money? And we can ask a question and get more information about money qualification, but let's go to number three, timeliness. Does he want to solve this problem now, today? That's why I tell you guys, close in the first phone call. I think we're the only sales system that tells you to go for the close or get at least a close commitment in the first phone call. I don't think anyone else teaches that. Or at least get another opportunity to close, another appointment or something on that. Do you think he's in the mood to solve that problem today if he's an 8, 9, or 10?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. You think he's going to say, well, Claude, you think he's going to say, well, no, I want to do this another year or two, wasting money. He doesn't want to do that. It's common sense, right?
Right.
We now need to find, is he the authority to make a decision? We don't know that yet. We think he is, though, don't we?
Yeah.
Don't we have a feeling he's a solopreneur?
Yeah.
Yes.
So we can go back in the conversation. And does he have the character? Does he sound like a righteous dude? What was that from? Bill and Ted's Adventure? Where did they get the right to do that? Okay. Or was that High Times at Richmond High? I try to think of all that. Who started that? What was that?
Bill and Ted's.
Bill and Ted. He's a righteous dude. So character is important in these things too. So those are the five qualifiers. On this. So let's go back in the role play, Bill, and see if we can fine tune this again. Then we're going to go to the commitment to close. What you didn't know this would be that long a role play, did you?
No.
Sorry. But am I being too micro on this, or is this okay?
No, because I have the big idea. It's trying to drill down, and I'll probably watch this like 10 times.
Yeah. Start with the I don't know. Could you help me understand? Not sure what you mean. What's the biggest challenge? Ask questions. Okay. You might even, you know, this is where you the acting comes in. You're going to play the role of a guy who's, I'm confused. Can you help me? You know, people love to rescue, don't they?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
They love to rescue. You're going to have to help me. I don't understand. So you're going to redefine. Do you ever ask somebody you don't understand? What do? They redefine their answer, don't they? They use different words. When they redefine, and when they redefine, do they give you this is the best part. This is where the prospect turns into the salesperson. Do they give you more information for you to make a determination that you can make, go to the bank today, or you're wasting your time? So Bill, back in the role play, let me ask you something. The budget for fixing this problem, you're spending all this money and everything else like that. What's your financial goal on this? Where are you now? It doesn't sound like you're making any money or very little. Now, and where would you like to be? If you don't mind sharing that with me.
Well, I would definitely like to be closing, you know, 3-4 deals a month.
How much would that do you think that would net?
That would give me like an extra $5,000 a month.
Okay. Is that comfortable for you? Is that your primary goal?
That's the primary goal.
So if you could get to five, let me ask you this. I'm just thinking out loud, but if you could get to 5,000 a month in the next 30, 60, 90 days, and you could reduce your expenses down to maybe $100 or $200 instead of 3,000. These aren't changes that you could implement right away, is it?
I would think, I don't know. I would think so.
Imagine for a moment that this is the imagine word, Dave Skolnick. Imagine for a moment that you and I started working together and I could show you how to close these prospects, how to get more prospects, how to lower your marketing expense to next to nothing, and how to do what you're looking for instead of hunting and pecking around and spending more and more money. I mean, you called me for a reason. Are you ready to solve this problem today? Are you the person who can make a decision today to solve this problem and get rid of that $3,000 a month expense? How do you feel about that? And it's okay to say no.
Well, yeah, I definitely want to, you know, make my marketing dollars go for something that's going to have a ROI for me.
Oh, yeah.
And that.
Imagine you were doing deals every month, every week. You got to that $5,000 goal. And you sound like you have a family, Bill? You have a spouse?
No, divorced.
You're divorced? Okay.
Yeah.
But you're probably a good-looking young guy like you. You probably have a whole bunch of girlfriends, right?
I'm a software guy.
Oh, shit.
Don't touch that one. They're either blow up or plug in.
Oh, boy, you stopped the whole show there. Oh, man, that was funny. help me, Suzette, take over. go ahead, Suzette. You can close them now.
Back to imagine.
So imagine for a moment that we're going to be able to take care of, help you bring up all those sales that you're looking for, bring up your income to that goal that you're looking for, perhaps, you know, surpassing that number. And how would that, you know, I what would you like to do next if that was the case?
Well, that's why I called you. I want to know what can I do next, because that's my goal, is to get there. And I really need you to help me out with it.
I have made a decision. That's what you say next. And you go into the cost.
All right, Bill. That sounds like you're very driven and you're ready to go to the next level. And that would be the consultation that I'm going to, you know, sit down with you and go over the numbers. So I made a decision today. I'm ready to
say that more dramatically. I'm sorry to interrupt. I have made, and take a pregnant pause. Bill, I've made an important decision.
Bill, I've made a decision today. We're going to work together. We're going to make this happen. And we're going to bring you to where you need to go. So we're going to have a consultation. We're going to put something together where we're going to work on this together. We're going to do some consultation with you to see what you're currently doing in details and bring it up to the next level. So there is a consultation fee, and it is a lot of money, Bill.
I love it.
It is a lot of money, Bill. So
sorry to interrupt again, but Suzette did this brilliantly. She just did a guts move. It's a lot of money. Now, he might be thinking $100,000, $50,000 or something like that. Okay, but she threw it right in front of him. See how honest Guts is? And now she's going to say whatever numbers in Suzette's head for the offer. Go ahead, Suzette. Sorry to interrupt.
No, you're good. So, Bill, you were saying that you were spending $3,000 in marketing, correct?
Correct.
Okay. So if I tell you that I'll charge you half of that, what would you like to do next?
Wow.
Review, do the five summary. Tell them, I will charge you half of that $3,000. You said you're spending too much money. You want to make money $5,000. You want to leave your engineer job. You want to meet new friends and things. What you want to be independent and work from. Reinforce. This is a commit to the close. We don't talk enough about this. This is where you regurgitate all his needs and greeds. Again, you want to keep him in that hypnotic emotional state. This is Guts 2.0 right now. You want to keep him emotional. He's going intellectual now. He's thinking about money.
Right.
Money can make you emotional or very intellectual. Okay. We want to keep him emotional. So do what you did before and then summarize why we're talking today. And then tell him it's okay to say no, but you're very busy and you only make the offer once.
Yeah.
Scarcity.
Okay. Go ahead.
Doing great.
Bill, it's half of that. But remember, we're going to work hard to reduce almost to nothing your currently, marketing expenses. We're going to also try new things that are going to reduce your time that you're spending, because I'm sure, like you said earlier, you want to spend time doing other deals and perhaps your job. So we're going to work into that really hard. And also remember your income that you're looking for, it's going to get there and surpass that. Oh, and your job, what's the job? I forgot the other one.
Yeah. You can leave that job you don't like and that nasty boss you were telling me about. It's role play. We can make up stuff.
That job that you say that you have, and perhaps you're trying to substitute it. That's why you're doing this on the side. And, connect with the right people too. That will bring you also additional deals that I'm sure you're looking for. Is that correct, Bill?
Yes, definitely.
So definitely. Bill, this offer is for today. I understand you're looking for something to do, but I'm also really, really busy and I don't want to go back and forth with different things. It's okay to say no today. And sure, you will continue to pay you $3,000 in marketing.
Excellent.
That is bringing you near nothing back.
Excellent.
Ouch, right, that Bill? Hurt. That hurt.
Was that too honest?
No.
Yeah.
No, this is music. This is like, I'm listening to Mozart here. This is wonderful. This is great. This is music to my ears because I love when you guys...
This is Maxi Award stuff right here.
This is Maxi Award stuff. This is good. Even the dog likes it.
Dogs know.
Bill, what would you like to do, Bill?
Next.
What would you like to do next, Bill?
Well, $1,500 is a lot of money.
It is.
No, it's not.
But, man, this would be saving me money in the long term. I think we should try it.
You think?
Well, yeah, I know. Yes, we should try it.
I'm sorry. You said, Mark?
Yes.
You've created a monster.
All right, Bill.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
All right.
Go ahead, Bill. I have a pen. Boom.
Here's my credit card.
Give Suzette and Bill a round of applause there. That was great. I love that. You just made $1,500 talking to a guy with a problem,
offering
solutions. The dog is bringing you a ball or a bone there, or is
bringing you a great bone.
Dog. I mean, that's what it's. We're having fun here and everything, but we're breaking it down to the different moments. There's moments in sales. These are the key moments. Instead of just flapping our gums and giving the presentation and telling them all the stuff they want to know or don't want to know, and then answering their questions because we feel subservient and submissive to them, we feign a little ignorance, we do a little redirection, we do a couple pattern interrupts, okay? And we go and then we slide into the agenda. You know what? I'm going to ask you a few questions. Then you go into qualification. No sense spending more time than necessary. It's the point of the timer. If you got someone who doesn't have the motivation, doesn't have the need, doesn't have the authority, it's in the wrong time frame or they don't have the money. Okay, Mr. Genius here. I've given million-dollar presentations to somebody who didn't have the money. I can't tell you how many times I've done that. before Max showed me, hey, what's the point? If they don't have the money, if they don't have the authority, if they don't own the property, if they are lacking in character, they're telling you about their you know, their five bankruptcies and things, and they're out of work and they live under a bridge. Why are you wasting time with this person? Okay, so we can be really smart about the way we qualify people. And then we go to the close, commitment to close. We get up, we do those micro commitments. Did you hear those little micro commitments throughout that role play? What would you do if you found a solution? Would you have that within your budget? How do you make decisions in your family? What's your family dynamic about buying this $4 million house or $1,500 program or this little consultation I'm going to help you with? So Bill, did you have any further questions on what to do here?
No, there are a lot of good pointers there. And looking back, I can see some of the spots where I made the mistake, you know, where I should have turned things or feigned ignorance. That was probably the biggest thing out of that, was to say, you know, I don't know, and try and get them to make the commitment.
It's going to be real hard to do this in the beginning because your ego is selling. I know the answer to that question.
Right.
Okay, I know the answer to the. I know the answer to that question. I can tell him the. And your uncle here is telling you, no, don't answer the question. Play the fool for a little bit of what. You're smart. You're being very sly right now because you're trying to get them. I don't understand. What do you mean by that? And this is going to be hard because inside your head, your mother's yelling at you. You know the answer. Tell him. Right.
Right.
And it's going to be hard. So you go the other way. I'm not sure if I quite understand. Well, you must be solving this. You've given all this money to this other program. You're spending all this money on mailers. You're doing all this pay-per-click advertising. It's probably making you a ton of money. And that's when you slide in the opposite, the redirection. And then they can't wait to correct you. No, I'm not making any money. No, I'm spending too much money. They're going to correct you. They can't stand it. Okay, they can't stand it. They will take over the conversation. And if you create the right environment with the right questions, you eventually get them to share everything you need to know so that you can close them in one phone call. Okay. Anybody have questions on this? This is a little technical today, but it's good. We've broken it down, I think, to the micro rather than the macro.
I have a question.
No, good role play. Yeah.
Thank you, Ben.
Yeah. So, you know, why are we wasting our time? I get a lot of, you know, I've changed my mind. I'm not interested anymore. I don't have the money now.
Oh, okay. Probably never will.
That's a pass.
Probably never will. Okay. Why change? You know, you got to deal with the cards. You've accepted me. This is where you do a guts move. Remember, I always say sales is dangerous. This is very dangerous what I'm going to teach you next. Maybe I shouldn't teach this. Okay, I've got a guy. He's on the emotional scale. He's a zero. He's gotten out the box of his box of boohoo tissues. He's telling me his life story and everything. Mm-hmm. This is when you have to put the cow electrodes, the prods, the cattle prods to him. Okay.
Yes.
And you say, you know, Ben, listen, I wish it sounds to me like you've just accepted mediocrity as a way of life. And that's just, you know, what were you hoping? So you're not willing to change or spend money or do anything different. So this is just your life as it'll be. Broke, not wasting money, going from guru to guru and not getting the, help me out. Why don't you think you deserve success?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And again, why would he waste his time helping him? And he's not really willing to put a little bit of, you know, effort in his own, for his own marketing. So that means that even if you give your job for free or give him a free advice, he's not going to do anything about it because he's not willing to put the extra
You're right.
Skin in the game.
Right.
We're trying to shock the senses here. We can get a we love the word yes from prospects, right? We make money. Yes. Oh, let's do this. And I'm always saying accept yes as an answer. So sometimes we want to keep selling and giving a presentation when they're ready to say yes. So accept yes as an answer. That's the best first answer. The second best answer is no, it's over. I don't want it. I can't afford it. I don't have the money. It's over. Okay. The third best thing you can get from a conversation. So we love the yes. We love the quick no rather than the meandering. Well, I'm going to think about it. I'm going to talk to my spouse. I'll get back to you someday. Never. Okay. And you're going to ask, and that's a waste. And that's good too, getting a quick no rather than that meandering no. And then the worst thing you could get is I'll think about it and you just, I'll get back to you. That's where you've lost control completely. And they don't respect you or your time. You're just a free consultant. Okay. Mm-hmm. But the fourth thing you can possibly get is a lesson. Practicing. Here you have live, real work. People always say, Claude, how do I role play? How do I get better at this? Even when you get a loser, when you get a non-functional prospect, a boohoo prospect, can you have a little fun with this stuff?
Yeah.
How does it affect your ego when you get to, and this is my words, I have this in my Guts Book of Rule. You're allowed to fire the prospect. None of this, the prospect is always right. They're not right, are they, all the time? No way.
No.
Can we
They're lying.
They're lying. How do you know a prospect's lying? How do you know a salesman's lying? We're all moving our lips, right? The thing about Guts is it's very dramatic. It's very honest. It's a little bit of science, a little bit of acting skill. So when I go to him and I'm saying, let me ask you a personal question. Promise you won't get mad at me. Okay, Bill. Okay, Ben.
Yeah.
I think it was Ben, right? No, it wasn't Bill.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Aren't you sick of accepting mediocrity as a way of life?
Yes.
What?
Yes.
You came to me for a reason. I want to help you. Is there some way we could stop? I have a feel. Let's forget about the money part for a second. If money wasn't an issue, forget about the money and the cost and everything else. If money wasn't an issue, would you want to work with me today?
Yeah, it sounds like the right idea.
I don't know what that means.
Everything makes sense. It sounds right. It's just I don't have the money.
Okay, but if money wasn't an issue, you would be able to make a commitment right now. If it was free.
Sure. Okay. Money weren't a problem.
Okay. See how he brightened up when I said free? Yeah. Okay. So I tell you what, I can't do it for free because I have a family, I have responsibilities, and we like to eat every day. Let me ask you this. Suppose I was willing to work out the money part, something that's comfortable for your budget. That wouldn't make a difference now, would it?
What can we do?
Boom, we're back in selling again. So you can either restructure the financing that opportunity. If he has absolutely no money whatsoever, it's dead. Get a lesson. How much can you learn by practicing with people like this, real world?
Okay.
You see, this is the part. How long can I control this person? How long can I keep them on the phone? How long can I get information from them? And I can fire them. I can cut the conversation off at any time I want. But how valuable is this learning experience?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's fantastic. Yeah. By the way, I wanted to acknowledge, we had some people pop up here. We had Felipe popped up there and Alina Rivera. Hi, Alina. And Brian is here, Mr. Bagnall. And Jimmy Jean popped in there too. How you doing, Jimmy?
Good afternoon, Claude.
Good afternoon, everybody. Did we learn anything today?
I wanted to make a comment on the way you were delivering those questions, and you had a breath in between and a pause to kind of like, it's almost like soap opera in a way. I mean, you took these breaks like, to really get his brain ticking, like, son of a bitch, I need to do something about myself. I'm pathetic. You know, so
being
if you review that last few seconds on the video when you redo this, that was masterful.
Sales is life to me. It's connecting with another human being so that they say, when you get, you know, hey, I like this person, I trust this person. Do you get that by just reading a bunch of, you know, intellectual gobbledygook to them? And oh, it comes in green and we're having a special and the price goes up on Friday and good thing you called me today and my competition sucks and yada yada.
It's like the doctor taking that breath before he tells you have mm-hmm. stage 4 cancer.
Oh, you're a demotivational speaker. Jeez.
But I mean that emotional thing, it's like it's not something like, hey buddy, you're gonna die in 3 months. You know, he takes a moment to show how much he cares.
Right. We want to show people we care. We also want to show them that there's that we have solutions to their problem. So if we can create that emotional stimuli, which is so important, and then and then go over all the needs and greeds, and then ask the questions that forces them to give it to it. See, we don't beg for the order. We make them, this is big now, we make them give it to us. You know how valuable, you know how great that is when a prospect makes the decision to buy rather than being forced or cornered or intimidated by the salesperson? When they see it in their best interest, when we buy things and we've made a decision, I'm gonna buy this car, I am sick of this other car that breaks down everything, I've made it. Isn't that a sense of relief when you made those important decisions in life?
Yeah.
There's so much emotion in sales, so much human behavior. And you're responsible for acting in the proper way to make them comfortable, not to be manipulate them or intimidate them, bully them, but we are responsible. Acting plays a part in this. Maybe you're having a bad day, okay? But when you talk to that prospect, what's your goal? You wanna make a sale. You want to turn it around. So you can't let them know you had a bad day or you've got a problem or something is going negative in your world. That's when you just press that little button and you go into gut sales mode. We're out of time. Boy, was this fun today, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We have a good time today? I wanted to go over. We've had three. I wanted to talk about the Guts Award, the Maxi. And this is for someone who you believe has demonstrated through their stories or their deals or their role play, somebody you feel has demonstrated that they really embrace the gut sales philosophy, the method and everything. Our first winner was Hugo Malara in 2018. I just spoke with him the other day. He's in Northern California. This is a guy who he's now rising up in the ranks of Google right now as a consultant. Since we've been working, he's become more assertive. We've got Esther Telez, who is just taking over Texas, doing owner finance real estate deals. And then last year, I finally got a jog to my memory here. I forgot. Last year, or 2020, was Felipe Bosanz. We all know Felipe. He was on here for a minute. Those are the three winners. I wanted to nominate and then open the floor to some nominations. There were three people that came to my mind for this year that really demonstrated gut sales ability. They made some money. They really did it. Tracy Phillips. Do you guys remember Tracy? He had that beautiful, did you guys watch the video? I put the link in the Skype group. I wanted to nominate Tracy Phillips. He did that, almost $3 million house. He made a year's salary in one deal, a really decent sale. He did that as a realtor and he made that beautiful video. You guys know I'm big on the marketing, attracting really quality prospects. My number two, he's one of our licensees, Justin Chamness. How many videos does Justin do? Oh my gosh, how many videos a week does Justin do? Justin and I started working together, I think less than a year ago. And Justin has just exploded his business with gut sales training. He's just doing fantastic. And I love all the videos and group training that he puts out. He's real. I thought he's done. And last but not least, I thought of Hervik Aliente. Hervik did that one deal where the people signed the contract on it. It was 140, 50,000 under market, something like that. They backed out of the deal and he solved the problem and closed on it. And he even showed us his check. He made a monster check on that deal, but he had all the problems and he solved them. So those are three people I'm nominating, and I'm going to send everyone an email with a ballot on these three. But who would you got? Let me open it up to you guys before we go too long here. And would anyone like to nominate somebody for the Guts Award? And that's a beautiful. It's going to be that beautiful. I showed you the picture before. I'll show it one more time.
Justin.
Justin. Justin has been nominated. That's great.
Yeah, but Justin has my award too.
Okay, there's the Max Award. It'll be for 2021. It's just a beautiful. It's a really a piece of artwork. This timer. It's a 60-minute timer. It's on plexiglass stand. You can actually use the timer too. It lifts up from the base there. So we got another vote for. We're not voting right now. We're just nominating. So another one for Justin. Anybody else? Who else would like to nominate somebody? Don't go crickets on me here.
I think Mr. Cashoffer.
Mr. Cashoffer.
He does really good role playing.
That's Chris Scott.
Chris
Scott, okay, very good. Yeah, Chris does a great job. Chris is always there with a role play. He's great at role playing, isn't he? Absolutely.
Is Victor your group or Justin's?
Victor's no longer with us in our group. He hasn't passed away or anything. He's no longer in the mentoring group. This is for mentees only.
Okay. I'm trying to think.
And somebody whistle the Jeopardy song. Anybody else? If you think of anyone.
Steve
Driscoll.
Yeah, from New York.
Okay, Steve Driscoll. That's a good one. Steve is great. Steve actually does his own class, group training with Guts from New York. Steve Driscoll. Steve's a good guy. He sends Claudia and I bagels from New York, from Queens every now and then. You had me at bagel, free bagel. Anybody else? Okay. Well, listen, so how did you, Stephen and Davis, you were there, this is your first time. How'd you like this group? This is a little longer than usual. I usually end on the top of the hour. How'd you like your first group call?
It was great.
I loved it.
Good. You think you took away something today?
Yeah, definitely.
Absolutely.
100%. I got all type of notes on what you guys were doing.
There you go. And we're recording this and it'll be posted in the Skype group. Later today in audio and video. It'll also be put in the Dropbox, and I'll probably email it to you guys too. David, you have a question.
I just highly
Don't tell us about another terminally ill doctor patient story.
No, I just highly recommend the new people hook up with you on Role Play Wednesday as well.
Role Play Wednesday. Yeah, Justin will be doing it this Wednesday on it. Role Play Wednesday is just a great way to keep practicing your skills. Learn the system. Practice the system so that when you get on the phone, there's none of the stress or what do I say next? Or, this is how practice makes perfect. And then when you see, this is the most important thing. When you start to see the results, when people start to say yes, or you get off of the phone with people who are manipulating you or wasting your time or being maybe not that their best manners, when you're making more money because you're using science and the system together, and you see the results, you can't help but say, I'm getting strong. I'm getting more confident. I'm going to the bank because, the thing about it is it's not the accumulation of wealth and assets. It's the ability to know that you could constantly just get to a phone and always make an honest day's dollar. Brian Bagnall, you're too quiet today, Brian. I'll give you the last word here.
What do you want me to say? I jumped in the last minute. Sorry.
Give us your favorite positive quote or book or favorite movie. Give us something positive.
I always like that one where it was, you don't lose until you give up. So
who said that?
I have no idea, but so
it sounds good. You don't lose until you give up. And do we ever give up?
No.
What did Churchill say when the Germans were bombing London day and night? What did Churchill say to the people of England?
I don't remember.
Never.
We will never, never, never give up. Because nobody deserves success more than you good people. Have a great week, everybody. Thanks for joining. We're going to go out with a little, you guys pick. We can do, how about a little Queen? Everybody likes Queen? Or Peter Gabriel? Sledgehammer. Haven't heard that in a long. Queen, Bohemian Rhapsody, or Peter Gabriel, Sledgehammer? What do you guys want? Can't hear you, Sean. Bohemian Rhapsody? Who doesn't like a little?
One of those is good.
Everybody needs a little Queen in their life, right? Freddie Mercury, baby. Take care, everybody. Have fun.
Have a good day.
All right.
Thanks, Claude.
Real life, is this just fantasy? Out in the land.